once again with another review for you, and this time I am reviewing a product from 4Team Corporation, and they've got something here that allows you to share your Outlook calendar contacts and everything in it, and I've been looking for something that is low cost, free, that will allow us to share the calendar. Now, there's a lot of things out there on the market, but there's been things like the Google calendar that will synchronize, and that worked well with XP, but apparently now with the Windows 7, that's not compatible. And Microsoft had something for updating that's built into Outlook, but it doesn't seem to be very reliable either. And there's a lot of other free stuff out there that just doesn't always seem to work that well. So when it comes to sharing a calendar, you're going to want to buy something to make sure it's reliable. And when you're sharing a calendar, it's most likely you're doing it for business use. And when it comes to business, you don't want to screw around with that. So I'm going to be showing you, I had the Share O, which is for sharing Outlook. And later I switched to just the Share Calendar, because that's all I wanted to do was share my calendar. And of course I came across an issue after doing that. So if you have any problems with the program, first of all, the tech support through this company is really good as well. They know their product very well. And there's a couple things that we found. And one of the things is switching from one version of the program to another, or for any reason, if you have to reinstall the program, you may find the data for the calendar stored in your roaming profile. So you would have to go to this directory and remove what's in it, basically, and then you can start over again. Once you set up the program, it will regenerate these files and set up the sharing again. Besides that, AVG antivirus, the new 2011 version, seems to have an issue conflicting with the Share Calendar program, but that's easily resolved, temporarily at least anyway now, by disabling the add-on for Outlook for the AVG program, and it works fine like that. Until either AVG comes up with an update that allows that to go through, or the 4Team Corporation comes up with an update that allows it to work with AVG, one or the other, they just need compatibility on that. But it does work with them by just disabling that add-on. Now, aside from that, the program itself, it works very well. We'll go into the Share Calendar here. And setting it up is quite easy. When you go in for the first time, you'd be going into Share. Oops. Now, you don't want to get confused between the built-in Share, which is for Microsoft, and the other Share option down here, which is for the Share Calendar or Share Outlook program that we're using. And when you go in there, you'll have all the options for what's being shared and how and that sort of thing. Now, when I get out of here, I want to... On the top of Outlook, you'll have a tab. If it's the new version of Outlook, like a 2010 version I have here, in this example, it's going to be another tab that says Share Calendar. If you go in there, you can go to the Management panel. And from here you can manage the sharing for everything. Now, if it's the Share Calendar program you purchased, all you can do is share the calendar. If you want to share any other files or directories, you would need to do that using the Share Outlook program. And you can set up different email accounts for who you want to share what with. And there's a lot of options available as well for how it's going to be shared. And when you set that up, it sends an email to the other person where they can then say where they want things to be shared. So you can integrate them, for example, your calendar and their calendar can remain looking the same, but share all the content between the two of them. But you could also have two separate calendars. So you've got the one that's being shared and the other one is your own private stuff. I like to merge the two together because you can still put on an option like this where it says to keep private things marked private and to have them blanked out so that nobody can see what those private appointments are. They'll just see that it's reserved time. So that works well. So the way this thing works, basically you would just add an appointment like you do in your calendar. The next time your computer does a send receive for email, it will include sending out a package that includes the changes that have been made to your calendar, whether you're adding, deleting, or modifying an appointment. It'll send that invitation to the person who you're sharing your calendar with. It will then automatically make those changes to their calendar without requiring any work at all on their part. They wouldn't even know what's going on. It would just simply update the calendar, and next thing they know, their calendar looks different. So there's no notification about that popping up, although it does show a little icon down by your time, which you could disable, and that tells you that there's been changes made. But really, everything happens automatically, so there's no need to train anyone on what to do. Once it's set up, you can have that going for all your staff, and it'll be fully automatic. So anyway, I recommend this product. I've been playing with it for a while. I've tried both full versions, and definitely is a good software program. The only issues I found were basically issues on my part for screwing around with it so much, and they were very easily resolved as well, along with the support of the team there in learning their product more, and it just works. So anyway, that's it. That's my review on the Share Calendar program. Links and information will be on here as well. Check it out, and thanks a lot, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Talk to you again soon. Bye for now.